Well, Miguel, we got your transmission apart, and it looks a lot worse than what it road tested till it got hot, because the oil pressure totally went away when it got hot. And where it was going away at is right here. This piston slash drum is cracked. It's got a set of clutches inside that fit in here, and also on the back side here. And I don't know if the camera is going to pick this up, but it is cracked right around here. And that's where, and what happened when it would get good and hot, the oil pressure that should push on the and apply the clutches was leaking past it, and then also the piston that fits in here was leaking past that as well. And the clutches are just burned up, metal to metal. I mean, there's just nothing left of them. This clutch plate should, believe it or not, look like that clutch plate. There's no lining left on that one. And these over here, same way. These things are burned up. And but when they got metal to metal, what happens is the electronics in here, the solenoids, are electromagnetic, and they just attract all that metal, and these solenoids are no good. And those are pricey boogers, and those have to come from Land Rover. Nobody else makes those. And in addition, the torque converter, which is between the transmission and engine, shares the same fluid and takes the place of a clutch. If you had a stick shift transmission, it's contaminated that, and that's no good as well. And so, in a nutshell, what we're going to have to do is rebuild the transmission and replace the torque converter. That's what's going to have to take place. We're also going to have to flush the transmission cooler system. Land Rover says when this kind of failure happens, you have to replace the transmission cooler, which is about an $800 item. We're going to be able to save you money with that. We're going to hot flush it. I'll show you that in just a minute. We have a state-of-the-art hot flush machine that flushes the transmission cooler to where you don't have to replace it. And that'll save you money. And I'll show you that in just a minute in a demo. But that's what it's going to be. Kenyon is going to write an estimate. It'll have all parts and labor, and we'll attach that as a PDF to this email. And it'll come with a 5-year warranty. It's going to be kind of pricey, because I wasn't expecting this to, based on what you said on how it shifted so well. And when I first got in it, it worked pretty good till it got hot. And then, man, it just went to hell in a handbasket real fast. But that's what it's going to take. And just either email me back or give me or Kenyon a call. But Miguel, I appreciate it. Thanks. Okay, this is our hot flush machine. And it's not hooked up to your car, but this is, it's going to be. And this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does is this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now it's only at about 179 degrees. And but it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. But let's see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. And this is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. But that's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.